second map in the DreamHack Steel Series CSGO Championship Grand Finals between NIP and NaVi, and we are ready with it. And it's NIP starting on the CT side of all things as well. They might get a little bit of a momentum boost just doing that, especially if they win this pistol round. It is a CT-sided map, this one. And looks like already NaVi deciding to go towards this B bomb site. They have the bomb there and everything, and because they have every single one here, it makes me think they might not try and switch down Pop Dog.
No, it doesn't look that way. It looks like they are going to be coming out into the inner bomb site, but still taking their time.
Yeah, slowly. And actually, that makes Getright sort of think again, because now they've been waiting for a while. Might end up being an A push after all, but smoke goes down. That's usually a big indication. Grenade, the money grenade! Oh, God! Devastating damage. NaVi run for the smoke. Viflaren with a triple spray down. He kills three members, and now Guardian finally with the return, but that's probably going to be too late. The rest of NIP are here. Another grenade. Edward gets a headshot. Forrest going to come in, and Guardian, they're fighting back. What is going on? Nothing but headshots from the Ukrainian and Russian team here. It's going to be in Slovakian. It's going to be Guardian and Edward in a one-on-two against Forrest. They turned it around in an impossible situation. Guardian gets the headshot. Lerpus, that was a mind-blowing turnaround. What did we just witness?
I have no idea how NaVi were able to turn that around. I mean, that was just insane. Viflaren with just an insane nade and then getting three kills here in the lower.
I mean, that should have been a fourth kill. He should have just mowed down four people right there. But he ran out of bullets, and then they turned it around from basically a 2-on-4 then. That was, well, in terms of changing your mindset, that might be the kind of round they needed, just having two people go all beast mode and do that. Good headshot early on here, and NaVi off to a decent start. Get right though with another shotgun. Are they going to walk right into it? Turns around, instant headshot. Edward, he doesn't even have a head anymore. He's just gone. And now, Get right going to fall back down, but actually still thinking about just walking back up for a second.
And once again, by the way, NaVi walking one at a time. There's no one to trade that kill on Get right, and he gets away with the shotgun, so poor work there. Looks like Getright is going to be peeking again, and he's going to see NaVi falling back. That's going to allow NIP to rotate.
Yeah, and they actually have Forest
and look at
and
that.
Existing armor.
Getright's actually on the flank now.
Oh, he keeps walking. He's walking up right behind. There's Viflaren taking down one. Getright again takes down Zeus. Now Starix and Guardian 2-on-4. Oh my god, Lerpus, it's happening once more. NaVi win a pistol round, and then NIP bounce back. And you did say earlier they must have had one of the highest ratios of doing exactly this. 2-on-4 at the moment. Starix comes in, and Guardian gets a good shot. But there's Viflaren again. Takes down Guardian. Starix fighting, but it takes a long time. And now he's in a 1-on-1 against one of the best clutch players in the whole world.
And Starix actually was a very good clutch player in 1.6, but in CSGO, obviously, Getright just had his number for the most part.
And he has
Let's
a good
angle. Now they've been spotted.
One shot, and
Starix comes up with a headshot, and that's actually huge for NaVi, because that would have been such a devastating blow mentally if they just won the pistol round once more and then just lost the second round.
Yeah.
Great play by Getright there, excuse me. Just really great decision to go for the flank there at the end. Barely misses the last headshot, but
oh yeah,
good
that's
stuff. And look at NIP.
Yeah, Glass Cannon AWP. They're gonna take the challenge against Guardian, and he's so fast. Instant lightning reflex. Viflaren is gone before he even realized what was going on then, I think.
I mean, that's what Guardian is known for, his fast reflexes.
And Forrest in the back, he's picked up the AWP. Edward gets another one. Forrest waiting for the crosshair, and that's an easy kill. Edward's down, he peeks once more. And Forrest, he's no slouch at this AWPing, but Guardian...
But Guardian is just one notch above, it seems. This is a shot there. Get right with a nice M4 headshot there.
That's a good return, isn't it? Cease comes up, misses the shot, goes for once more. Cease takes almost a day to kill Freiburg then, and then it's going to be Getright with the instant return. And Getright seems on fire right now, which
yeah,
is obviously a terrifying precedent here for NaVi.
It's actually a scary 1v2 situation, I think.
He's going for it.
No,
NaVi.
No kit for Getright, though.
Right, he's going to have to be pretty quick, and he goes down. Starix will get it, so they had him locked in that lane. But that could have almost been Guardian, though, carrying a lot in that round.
Indeed. Guy smiling there. Just happy to be around.
Oh,
nice shot by Guardian there. And I don't think he even noticed by then that Viflaren actually had a knob. So I don't think they yet knew that NIP had.
No, because that would have been, that is very unlikely. You can watch 100 train games and probably never see that kind of vibe with just the glass cannon in the second round. And it's obviously based on the fact that they had such a successful, you know, second round, so the third round, sorry.
Yeah, and of course that Viflarion actually got so many kills on the first round that allowed him to have enough money. Getright takes out Zeus. Not really sure how that happened, but once again, Na'Vi are doing this thing where they peek one at a time. Zeus is already dead. Zeus is down to low health, and it once again looks dangerous.
Yeah, they need to stop doing this.
And look at
this.
Edward here. He's going to be swarmed by counter-terrorism here in a second.
Gets the one. If they jump down, actually, he's just going to go down. What?
Why does he peek? And this round is looking terrible for Na'Vi once more. It's a 3v3. Two of the NIP players have AKs. It's not looking good.
Oh, Starix comes out, gets the one. Right.
Well, Starix has been the man for Na'Vi so far.
It feels like it, doesn't it? They need
well, it's because it's true. And that's a 3-kill for Starix. Bails Na'Vi out once again. That's going to make it 4-0.
So what here, Lurpus? Between Starix and Guardian, is that going to be enough of an engine to drive Na'Vi to a victory on train?
It's not going to be enough of an engine alone. They're going to need everybody to chime in. I mean, so far it's been the two of them, but they're going to need more support from everybody else.
So far, it's a 4-0 lead here on the less favored side of train, so that's a good start. But now there's an auto sniper on Getright and AWP and Viflarion, and we've seen in the past how effective this can be, particularly on this map, which is like the origin of the auto sniper in Global Offensive, basically.
Yeah, I believe it was Getright, too.
Yeah,
might have been
exactly.
The very first player who started doing that. Starix misses a shot there, had a chance to take out Freiburg in alley, barely does any damage. Yeah, and Na'Vi actually look like they have the bomb in the white halls, so they might actually still revert back into the inner bomb site or fake the inner site and go back outer. We'll see what they choose to do here with 1 minute remaining on the round. Yeah.
And there are so many options on train. Because of that pop dog area, you can actually rotate so quickly around. So obviously it's something NIP going to have to try and see if they can keep track of. With train now, it's difficult because they're really far back on the map. Nobody's getting much of any information. I mean, what can you do at this point? Count smokes, basically, to try and guess where the players are?
It's more or less. Let's see. The push is going to come from here. It's going to be 30 seconds left on the clock. And Getright is going to be the key player here with this auto sniper.
Yeah, way in the back. So even if they smoke off, that won't help.
Yeah, a lot of his own bad timing by Getright to move, but he has now spotted the push.
Yeah, Forrest's going to get the kill, so that really works now. The four main members in, Guardian takes down Getright, so no auto sniper action this round, and that's obviously a hugely important kill. And he's still in the backup here. They smoke off towards the connector as well. This is going to be tough for NIP now. Edward with another kill. He's going to go down eventually to Freiburg, and Guardian is gone. Seize with the kill. Now 2-on-2. It's not over yet. Now it's a 1-on-2. Seuss has to step up and save his team here. The captain of Na'Vi running up, and I don't think they realize where he is. They're going to go for one defuse, but that's surely going to be a kill. Seuss picks that one, and now he can just hide. This is very nicely played from Seuss. Intelligently done. He's trying to hide here, and he gets Viflarion. A great save from Seuss, and they win the round.
Yeah, I mean, that was going to be a very tough 2v1 for NIP just because of where the bomb was planted and the fact that Viflarion had an op. So it was going to be almost impossible for him to cover all the areas where Seuss could have been. Still nice play by the in-game leader of Na'Vi, and it's going to put him up 5-0. Very good start for them.
Oh, man. And NIP, they get close that round. They're very close. In fact, so close they feel like we're just going to be buying a Max 7 and some FAMASes here to try and see if they can seal the deal. Na'Vi, I mean, 5-0. What do you think? Is it looking convincing yet?
You never really know. NIP can still go on a run, and if it's 10-5 and win the second half piss run, what are you going to say then? So, I mean, it all just depends how the rest of the half plays out, who's going to win the second half pistol. Forrest gets a pair of kills there early on.
He's had enough here. He just wants to win a round, but Seuss will take him down. Still looking good for NIP in this round so far. They just need to get one more kill in, and that should pretty much be it. Bomb still all the way over at the white holes, and Na'Vi slowly pushing on towards the A bomb side, at least with one person. Getright in a beautiful position. He misses a shot that he should never have missed, but he's going for more. He's not even scared. Gets the one, gets the double. Bomb is down, and now Seize is going to die to Freiburg, and it's Getright again.
I'm actually surprised. I believe that was Zeus who threw up the ladder. I'm surprised he wasn't expecting Getright to keep pushing. Like, he completely bailed on looking that way, and that's what allowed him to get these two kills. Yeah, it was Zeus. So nice play by Getright. Once again, very nice timely push.
He actually does not even look back. So once the bomb is down, that's pretty much it. 5-1. And finally, NIP pick up around. They have an AWP and Viflarion as well. I think they maybe stole that somewhere else. And that's going to be a pretty good start for them.
Guardian with a pick on Freiburg in alley.
And boosted up on the fence, I think, which is always a cool idea, because it's pretty difficult when you have to watch two levels as a single person there. So, well done.
I mean, it's basically impossible. So when someone's on the fence, you really just can't be looking into alley. You can't be peeking that deep. Looks like Navi might actually be setting up to attack the outer bumps. This gets its opening frag here. Forest gets one as well. Looks like Forest looking for the second kill.
Yeah, jumping and shooting at the same time.
Yeah, but two Navi players still falling back towards the middle.
Just a single smoke left on Guardian here. So if they run in, they're going to be shot from every which angle. I mean, this is a really open bomb site. So if you don't smoke it off and just run in, chances are you're going to have a really hard time covering all angles. Actually, because they only have one smoke, I kind of like the idea that they might go to the B bomb site instead. But no. What? Are they going down? It seems like they might.
Looks like they might be coming out the ladder. Yep. 24 seconds. Guardian needs to get this pick, but no, it's Zeus who peeks first.
Maybe and a bit of a mistake.
Taken out. Yeah, it probably should have been Guardian peeking first, but I think it's because they didn't know if anybody was playing nearby.
Look at the
bomb needs to get planted ASAP, and I think Exist is going to be able to get this kill. Yep.
And that's the round. 6 seconds left. Nothing to lose, nothing to win here. An NIP pick up the second round. And the crowd is pleased about that one. Pretty excited down at the Dream Arena here. And NIP, they're slowly getting back into it. I mean, there's still some sort of scary rounds, but it seems like they've recovered from that initial 5-loss streak.
Yeah, now Navi are actually broke, so that's gonna be a third round for NIP. It's gonna build up a lot of money for them. And I mean, Navi even got the pick last round early on, but they just weren't able to use that for anything really. So really did not look good at all for Navi there. I feel like you should be able to get more out of getting an early pick like that.
Yeah. Well, not this time, it seems. C's walking up very close. Oh, he had a CZ 75. That might have actually been dangerous, but the Glock is nowhere near as good. And Freiburg picks up two quick kills against the pistols. That's actually maybe one of the first rounds we've seen where nobody's bought a CZ 75. This whole tournament.
Navi actually had only $200 worth of equipment there, I think.
So nicely done from NIP. They lose the single player, but they managed to keep on to the rest, and that's obviously what they need at this point anyway. We'll see. Setting up here for the ninth round, and it's all AKs, so no AWP, which was one of the big problems earlier in the first map here for Navi, is that they never got that AWP on Guardian. This time, they go without it.
Yep.
It's not necessarily a completely devastating decision, but we'll have to see if it works out or not, because he's been getting some good picks already on this map.
He has indeed, but we'll see what Navi chooses to do. They really have been successful going to the inner bomb site, so I would actually expect them to keep hitting that, but let's see. Tufarin is playing there with an AWP.
Yeah, they hear it, so I feel like some of the more dangerous AWP players are the type that will, you know, once their position is known, they'll move around a lot. So Tufarin seems to be sort of still up there, so I would wish he would switch position with somebody else so that they would keep guessing where that AWP might be. Get right, still down on slope, waiting. Still a good amount of grenades onto NIP here. So when the push comes, they'll have some flashbangs to throw against Navi. Timer says just about 40 seconds, and Navi have a lot of grenades left. They're just waiting the time down here for an eventual push, but nobody from NIP is even peeking anything.
Nope, Edward really needs to get a peek here on Fufar, and he's playing very close up with an AWP. That could really open up the round. Starix doesn't get the kill. Fufar, on the other hand, doesn't. It's just looking terrible for Navi here. Exist with the second kill of the round. It's going to be another round for NIP.
No doubt about that. Get right, not even moving an inch. Just crouching, getting the kill. One miss from Baron. Second shot, actually, it's going to be Get Right to take him down. It's a good headshot from Guardian. But in the grand scheme of things, it doesn't really matter at all. Navi's still going to lose the round. And when's the last time they put down the bomb in a bomb site?
Round four, maybe?
Yeah. So that's quite a while ago. And that's, I mean, actually, this is something that Thorin pointed out quite a while ago to me, is that one of the reasons why it's really sick that Train is such a terror-sided, or such a CT-sided map, is the fact that it's actually fairly easy to get the bomb down once you just have a few smokes and flashbangs, and it seems like Navi aren't even really accomplishing that much right now.
Well, the problem is, Navi could do, like, the smoke attack into the outer bomb site, where you just run behind the barrel and get the bomb planted early on.
Yeah.
But the thing is, the same problem why it's no longer very easy to defend the site as a counter-terrorist because you can't hide under the trains and there's not a billion spots for you to check.
Yeah.
It's the same reason that it's not easy to win those after plans as a terrorist because there's only so few places you can actually hide. So it's really hard to win the round sometimes, even if you do get the bomb planted, if there's multiple counter-terrorists left alive.
Yeah, they certainly haven't done it yet. So, I mean, they must have a reason, because obviously now we know the strategy and know how to execute it. But we'll see if it's going to come out a little bit later. This time, well, they're back to pistols. They've at least picked up some CZ-75s. They realize the Glocks aren't enough. And Freiburg in a position to get some excellent frag movie kills here. Flashbang comes out, though. Very nicely done. Freiburg somehow still alive. He's going to go down eventually, but Forrest will pick up the kills instead. Gets the double, gets taken down from behind, though. Guardian will drop him. And it's actually down to a 2-on-2. This is a hugely successful eco round from Na'Vi, and if they can win it, it'll obviously be huge. Exist goes down. And now it's on Get Right here. 1-on-2, and they are going to be able to put the bomb down. He does have a grenade. It's going to rain in. That will kill him instantly. Now a 1-on-1. Guardian peaks out. Get Right. He saves the round for NIP, and he even looks completely unfazed, like that was no issue.
Yeah, and Get Right just very smart play there. Hits the nade perfectly, takes the first opponent out, and then he knows where the second guy is. So almost like a standard 1v2 clutch for Get Right. Just play here. He just waited for Guardian to peek, and once he did, that was an easy kill for him. So
what? You must be joking. Two auto snipers and one AWP. NIP, they're no longer going to be playing any games here. I mean, what do you think about this, Lopez?
Well, I think this is their way of just attacking Guardian back. Because Guardian has that op. He's been good at getting picks. So they want to get some guns with some zooming abilities as well.
And they already got a really good grenade on him there. Down to 54. I think that was Get Right throwing that grenade. And trying to guess the angle through. Yeah, I mean, seems like a reasonable plan. Guardian pretty good at opening, so we just get three scope rifles in return. See what he says about that.
That's three against one, man.
Not fair. And okay, so this, you said it earlier, you really can't do this. So Freiburg's answer to that idea is just, well, I'm just going to be pre-peeking, and if they come lower, I'm screwed, but I'm just going to be gambling. It's a 50-50 chance, basically.
Yeah. Let's see what happens here. Na'Vi look to be heading towards the inner site in just a second here. Or are they actually going to go down the ladder? Could still be a fake, I guess, but...
Yeah, they have the time
for it. They are going to go to the inner site. Get Right gets the first kill.
Yeah, picks up one, goes for a second. He's going to get it. Eventually goes down. Forrest takes down Guardian, so the AWP is gone, and he's still got the auto-sniper up on the high ground, just surveying the bomb site. Grenade is going to rain down. He spots the person. That's a lot of information. They know where he is now, and Forrest isn't done yet. Clicking away, Edward actually picks it up and will take him down now. 2-on-2. Na'Vi need this round. They need to get back into this game, and there's the headshot. Freiburg goes down. It's on for Flaren, and clutching with an AWP is pretty damn difficult, even in this bomb site.
It really is. I mean, there's just such a close distance fight. And oh,
what?
It's a sick shot by Fiflaren.
Oh my god. A woof just went through the audience. He gets the no scope. Fiflaren, please. There is no time, but that was definitely mind bending. He's going to be running out of the bomb site. He survives the round, but that was such a sick performance.
You know, if you take the name out of it, you'd actually think that it'd be Guardian playing there or Kenny
S.
Yes. One of those two. So just great play by Fiflaren. We see that again. I mean, first shot on Edward through the train, and then the second no scope on Seized here. Unfortunately, no time to defuse the bomb, because that would have been a sick clip if he still got the defuse as well.
That might have been one of the tournament highlights if that actually worked out with the defuse.
Yeah. For this match's sake, I'm glad that Na'Vi were able to win that round, because that would have probably just taken all the remaining wind out of their sails.
We'll see. 6-5 here, and we're into that 12th round. And Na'Vi, I mean, after basically a 5-round losing streak, they finally pick it up again, which is very good here. How many rounds do you think they actually need on the T side, Na'Vi?
I think they're getting to that sweet spot. I mean, if they get to 7, I think that should be an okay terrorist side for them. Now, the problem is, if they lose the pistol round, it's easy to get in a situation where you have to save a lot, so...
Yeah.
A pistol round and even 6 rounds would be enough, I think. But they really need that second half pistol, because NIP is terrifying with a pistol round. And once again, Get Right with just 2 kills, and Na'Vi just not clearing that area.
Yeah, he's looking for more. Third headshot coming up. He's controlling the bomb. He wants a quad kill. He's looking for the frags here, and just one click is going to be enough for Starix. He's on 12 HP. I'm not sure Get Right realizes where he is, and it will be Freiburg picking it up, but... I mean, the power of Christoph Allison here, just absolutely insane. Even after the first kill, where they know where he is, they still seem to not be able to kill him.
Yeah, I mean, the problem is, it was basically the same thing as on that save round. First of all, no one really cleared it. Edward just peeked with his smoke out. He was getting ready to execute into that site with the smoke, and they hadn't cleared the close area where Getright actually likes to play fairly often. And then, after that, there was no one to trade, because Guardian obviously had an op, and that's just a very tough shot at such a short distance.
Mow down from Freiburg, no issue at all. He's up against just a pistol, and the score is 6-6, so it looks like Na'Vi aren't going to be having much to say in this round at all.
No, it certainly doesn't look that way. Na'Vi on a save, and it should be another textbook round for NIP, who should be going for the lead for the first time. It's going to be their first lead in the second half here. I mean, second map, rather, sorry.
So even though there might be a good reason why Na'Vi have decided those A smoke pushes aren't really worth it because the defense is hard afterwards, it still feels to me like if you throw in one round where you do it and test it to see if NIP are actually good at holding it or not, then you at least have that information, whereas it seems like they're doing a lot of the same pushes right now.
Well, I mean, Na'Vi used to do that check. I mean, we've seen them do that before,
yeah,
some time ago. So, I mean, it's just possible that they've just realized that it just doesn't work for them.
Oh, man. Currently, NIP taking the round lead and looking, I don't know, they're looking focused right now. I don't think any of the teams are super hype at the moment. But obviously, NIP, they have a little bit more of a reason to be relaxed, having already won the first map, which was Na'Vi's map pick.
Yeah. And Na'Vi here just hoping to get one more round. Then they really would have a really good first half score here. See if that happens or not. Looks like Na'Vi are looking to maybe go towards the outer bomb site this time around, but Edward is in the inner side. He's actually clearing the area where Getright has killed him twice now, so he's at least finally learning from his mistakes.
That third pistol on charm, Guardian, right? Does that mean they're going to be buying an orb on Guardian for the last round? Can we have the scoreboard quick just to see what's going on for Guardian's economy? So he's got 1,000. I actually won't even have enough.
Well, no, he just didn't have money for a rifle.
All right, well.
That's kind of a weak fake by Na'Vi, but it actually draws a mini rotation from NIP, and that might be enough for Na'Vi to get into this site.
Yeah, one entry kill is what it takes. CSC's trying to see if he can secure it for his team, but NIP staying hidden for a long time, and it's going to be Forrest instead with the return. Cease is down. Forrest with a quick double. Get right, Freiburg as well. Edward goes down, and that's a triple for Forrest, and another round that Na'Vi really needed to win. This last round of the half, they really won't have almost any money.
And now we might actually see something fast to try to surprise NIP, but the problem is at this point NIP really expects something different. So, I mean, NIP really just picked up the slack at the 5-0 deficit. From that point on, they're 8-1 and they're favored to win this final round as well. So, really strong play by them ever since that initial rough start.
15th round coming up. One AK point to Leo. Have to be a really magnificent shot from Guardian to clear up one part of the map. I mean, that entry frag is everything right now to Na'Vi, it feels like.
The problem is, Train is such a wide open map that even a single entry kill won't get you access to a bomb site in the same way that it does on, for example, Inferno. Edward very close to just burning to death there.
he was in the worst possible spot, I think, for that Molotov to land. Let's get it right. There's Forrest. Each headshot, he's finally going to get taken down, but it might be too late here. It's a 3-on-3. Duflaren with a very good pick, just crouching, getting that shot. He's going to go down, though. So it's on get right again. 1-on-2, and he's won a fair few of these already in this tournament.
He's got the bomb down.
You're absolutely right. He's covering the bomb. I think they realize he's going to be here, and actually, he's a little bit slow in the reaction time there, so Starish will take him down. And Na'Vi, in the last round, they pick up that golden 7th round for themselves.
Yeah, an 8-7 first half. For Na'Vi, that's a very good first half as a terrorist. Obviously, NIP regained control after 5 rounds, and they just looked far better from that point onwards. But 7 rounds on T-side, if you ask Na'Vi before this half begins, how about this? We give you 7 rounds, we don't play the half. They're going to say yes.
Yeah, that's a good way of measuring it. Gray face, no space, and there's the other one. Easy skins, easy life, and the Forest troll face in the corner.
Yeah, that troll face is pretty good.
It is.
Gotta give Forrest credit for that. That one's good.
Yeah, well, there's gonna be some people losing some skins here, as there is almost every day, and there's always a fair bit of rage to follow. I don't know if you've noticed this, but
yeah, I've noticed.
Which has its own value in comedy, I think. There's something funny about this too.
Yeah.
Alright, NaVi starting off on the CT side. This should be the more favored side. If they can win this pistol round, they might actually have a chance of doing this, but already headshot through the smoke. Caesar's down to 11, and it's the Glock train. Exist, bombardment. Caesar's dodge down. Exist now with the triple kill. They're making it work. NIP, in spite of NaVi having a lot of people in that A bomb site, it wasn't enough for that kind of carpet bombing. Now, Get Right, he's over here, he's listening, he can hear them when they run around the back, so he has a pretty good counter where they are, and Zeus is very low, the bomb is down. Tiflaren chiming in, and it's Guardian, 1-on-4 here, and really no chance to win this any longer. Exist is not going to get the kill, it's going to be Get Right instead. That kind of start was brutal.
Yeah, I mean, that nade just demolished, just devoured any hopes NaVi may have had of winning that pistol run. Zeus instantly got gooshed through the smoke into Alley, so that was a little lucky in NIP's part. I'm not sure how the second guy got tagged up, might have been through Alley, but then Exist just with a perfect nade, and then follows that up with a third kill. Good job by him, and that should now make it 11-7 in favor of NIP, so for NaVi to still stay competitive, they really have to win the fourth round and just really start stringing rounds together from that point on, assuming they don't win a save round here.
That would be something. Already they get the one kill here. Zeus is pretty low on health and he's going to get taken down by Forrest. But yeah, coming back into it right away would be huge. But Driver, go, pretty good control. He's going to take the one and very nearly gets the second one. So Seized is alone. And the really sad thing is that Seized can't even like pick up a rifle and run away because they've all died so far away from him. So he eventually just dies trying to escape, I think.
I think we see the crowd.
Yeah, looking fairly cheerful.
Yeah, I mean, they're happy.
In spite of the hour here, because we were heavily delayed towards the grand finals here, thanks to Hearthstone. So, what time is it actually right now?
It actually is 12:47.
12:47. People still up to watch Counter-Strike. I hope you guys at home as well are having a grand time with the finals here. Looks like NIP are pretty close to being able to take this, but we can't rule out NaVi yet. We need to see how they're going to perform once they get the rifles.
Yeah, the fourth round is going to be key, as well as the rounds after, but fourth round, if NaVi lose this, they have almost no chance of winning this.
Yeah, that'll be an extra round. That'll mean NIP just need to win basically three more rifle rounds or something like that. It's going to be very close at that point. Or sneaking up, going to take down Guardian, and somehow realizes Evo is there. Keeps spraying, gets another one. Actually, that was Exist stealing it, and another kill for the in-game leader of NIP. So that will be a fairly easy round for the Swedish champions. Now we get to see what NaVi can do. What kind of setup do you expect from them here in the fourth round?
I mean, you don't do anything special. You gotta assume your default game works. Guardian does not have an op, so that's odd to me. I would expect him to have a big rifle, but let's see. Let's see if this works out for NaVi.
So far, not doing much damage. Star is in a great position. Oh, wow, well played. Gets Get Right and Freiburg, and anytime you kill Get Right, it's a pretty good day. If you're NaVi, Edward with a kill, and there's Guardian. Nothing but headshots here for this for the counter-terrorist team, and it's going to be Forrest left alone. So that's a cleanup if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, that's a very quick round in favor of NaVi. Not able to pick up an op from NIP because they didn't have one, though, but now it's very important that the NaVi players just don't push anywhere and die.
And they get the kill, so there it is, a flawless round.
It's actually funny, you hear Seized yelling, and there's just no one else yelling. Because all of the crowd is on NIP's side. So that actually sounds pretty funny there. We see replay of Starix's two kills here with the silenced M4. Good job by him in the alley area. And another round for NaVi. Really important none of their players died, but they need to win more.
They need even more. They need a hell of a lot more right now. And it's possible. It's definitely possible on the CT side. A little bit of momentum, some good engagement, and that's probably all it needs for NaVi to potentially extend the series off to Dust 2, which would be, that would be interesting at that point.
It would indeed. Well, let's see what happens here. Seize has taken some about 60 health points of damage.
Freiburg, he remembers how he died down there, so he's like, I'm just going to try the same thing.
Hasn't spotted anyone yet though. Guardian still without an op in his hands. Obviously didn't die the previous round. Not gonna throw an M4 out. And really, really important round here. Because if NaVi are able to somehow win this round without allowing NIP a bomb plant, there's actually a chance NIP have to save. And that actually is what would happen if there were no bomb plant. So that could be huge for NaVi. Just boost their money situation by so much and actually just give them a chance to string some rounds together here.
Yeah, put NIP in a really bad spot economically too, especially if they just can't get that bomb down. But look at this. This is what we were sort of we were talking about with NaVi. They weren't doing these smoke executes. Looks like NIP are going to try and do it, though. There is a Molotov blocking half the team. So actually, NIP just split up in their forces here. They're still trying to push, but they're going to go down. Guardian and Zeast with some good headshots here. Finally return. Forest going to get down Edward, but Zeast isn't done. He's going to get another couple of kills, and Starish will finish it off. So even though they lost two players, NaVi pick up that round, and really convincingly.
Yeah, Zeast picks up three kills, and I'm not sure if this is another game or if NaVi actually do have some fans after all.
I think there are actually some right in front of us just shouting and cheering. Yeah, look at that,
yeah,
guys.
No, we got a couple NaVi fans here.
Excellent.
They're a little outmatched, though. I don't know. We might have given some extra mics, some access to loudspeakers.
Yes, representing still as very nice.
Even it up a little bit. So NIP now on a save round. That should allow NaVi to get within one round. And considering they're playing on the easier side of the map, all of a sudden we do have a game in our hands, guys.
It feels like it, doesn't it? Against, well, I'm not going to say against all the odds, but certainly the odds seem stacked against NaVi for a very long time here in this Grand Finals. But maybe it's going to turn. It's going to come down probably to the next buy round for NIP to see if the Swedish team can turn it around again. And are they going to try and actually run down and put the bomb down here? They got the smokes for it, certainly. And this is, I think it's one of the things that Thorin was talking about earlier. That grenade could have been absolutely beautiful, but somehow it doesn't do them enough damage. Guardian, Zeus, and Edward still picking up great kills. And the bomb plant is not happening right now. They're trying to see if they can get it done, but no. They're not going to be working here. Getrai gets the one kill, and NaVi defending solidly once again.
Yeah, Guardian also seems to be finally heating up. He just got the same number of kills that round as he did in the entire first map. So, I mean, we talked about the importance of Guardian's play to NaVi's success. So, he seems to be heating up. Things are looking pretty solid for NaVi. They're actually tied 3-3 here in the second half. And they need six more rounds to take this down to dust, too.
Yeah. On the more favored side, with a much better economy than NIP, it's looking good. There is Seized, killing Freiburg as he runs through the fire. And there's Zeus with a good... Actually, that grenade didn't do any damage, but another one that could have been really great. Zeus trying to see if he can fall back smartly at this point, actually. Edward is going to get one kill as they try and enter the speed bomb site. Baron with a great double kill takes down Zeus and Seized. It's not over yet. Geraint spraying through. He's going to take down Edward. And that turns it around. Even though the bomb is down here, NaVi can still do this. But they just had a massive lead and they lost it.
It's going to be tough to retake the site with Guardian having an op. It's so hard for him to move up closer. And he misses the first shot. I think that was the key to this round. And Guardian is going to have to try to save. But Geraint is already on the flank here as usual.
Yeah, he's ready for it. Guardian not going to be escaping here unless he can kill somebody, everyone, as they try and creep up on him. But they don't want him to save it here. One on two, and he gets downed by Exist. And there it is. NIP, I mean, for a minute I was thinking, all right, it's almost over, but still plenty of time for NIP to bring it back.
I think it's a replay of Seeds. Seeds getting some kills. No, it's actually the Fifarin double. In the inner. Nice kills by Fifar, and he's really been stepping up his fragging game.
Yep.
In this grand final.
Yeah, it was really nice to see him play in that style. And something that NIP obviously need, as every other team starts playing better and better. NIP going, actually all of them, over towards the B hallways, which is where I would like NaVi, if they were creeping out, I mean, on they can't know this, but if they every once in a while was looking towards Ivy and maybe checking T-spawn, they'd have a lot of information right now about what NIP at least weren't doing.
Still lots of money for NaVi for this round. Guardian has an op. Everybody else has the gun of their choice.
Zeus is where Getrai
used to be. Look at that. Guardian spots. First guy can't shoot in time. And then Freiburg connects on the shot. Zeus needs to get a second kill here. He can't allow himself to die. But Freiburg with a second entry kill this round.
Yeah, maybe Freiburg has decided it's actually time to win now. Like on Dust 2. We'll have to find out. It's going to be Freiburg again. This time a triple kill for him, and he's looking for one more, and there's a chance he can get it. Edwards alone in a 1-on-4, and he's actually already making a run for it. No chance here. So that's two rounds for NIP in a row, and now a 13-10 scoreline, and the money for NaVi is not looking good. Were they just baiting them? Were they just, you know, stringing them along for a while until it started feeling comfortable, and then they smacked them down at the end anyway?
Yeah, I don't think teams actually do that on purpose. Especially not in the deciding half of the grand final when
definitely
they don't exactly
not.
have the largest lead. in the world, but it's getting dangerous for Na'Vi. I'd like to see their money now. Just get an idea of whether or not they'll be able to buy here.
Don't think they can. And if they had to force up with Famasis, I think, if they wanted to try and go for it, I actually don't think they could do it. Not happening. Edward, the one with the M4A1, so probably gonna be 14-10, at which point Na'Vi more or less need to win 6 rounds in a row.
Yep. That's gonna be a tall order against NIP here. We have all of a sudden had a lot of success attacking the inner bomb site against Na'Vi. I mean, the outer site, Na'Vi were able to shut out completely, basically, those couple of rounds, but on the inner site, they've struggled.
They definitely have. And you gotta wonder if they're not really making much of a rotation here. Sue's the one defending still. Forrest gonna creep up. He actually gets down by Edward, who peeks once again, and it's gotta be careful. He's kinda low on health, and Freiburg will take him down. Another headshot. And another kill. 3-on-4 here, and the bomb's gonna go down.
Of course, I mean, it's not really a real 3-on-4. Save for Na'Vi, they don't have any kits, so it's gonna be a round for NIP. It's just a matter of playing it out. Yeah. That'll be 14-10 now in favor of NIP, and remember, they already won the first map of this series, so they actually are 2 rounds away from winning, and actually defending their championship from last year's DreamHack Summer.
You are right indeed. Last year was Epsilon that they beat in both the DreamHack Grand Finals, but also in the Swedish SM Finals. Bit of a switch up this time. It was actually Fnatic that beat them in the Swedish SM Final, but, you know, they get to this anyway. They get to do this. Well, if they win the next 2 rounds, that is. Oh, we're just ready and waiting. Next round coming up, the 25th here, and Guardian again without an AWP Lurpus. I'm not sure about this. It seems to me like this is a bit of a replay from what we're witnessing on Inferno, where they didn't have the economy to get the equipment, and as a result, they just never really were able to perform.
And look at that. They just made it. Starix there in alley.
Yeah.
So that's going to be tough. Deflaring gets a second kill.
Yeah, they say revenge is a dish best served cold, but I think it's much better served with a hand grenade right to the face. Edward, Guardian, Seuss left 3-on-4 here, and they all have pretty much full health, but they're doing. Train is a big map. They're spread out all across it.
Freiburg and Getright down to low health, so if now they can just stack the right bomb site and actually take some aim duels, they have a good chance of winning this round still.
And NIP playing very slowly. They're really hoping that Na'Vi is going to get, you know, a little bit anxious at this, you know, having one man less and maybe going for a little bit of a peek. And if they do, that certainly play right into what NIP are thinking. But now, as the clock runs a little bit lower, 40 seconds left still, they're sort of moving towards this B bomb site.
Indeed.
And there's one person defending here. And actually, maybe one guy rotating over. So Na'Vi have a, maybe, oh, Guardian, he's at least thinking about it. It would be a good read if they did it.
See what Getright does here. He's going to be walking out. Is he going to spot someone? He doesn't see the guy in tower, does he now?
Oh,
he does, but he's not going to take the shot yet. This is just 17 health going to be taken up by Guardian. Look at this rotation from Zeus, though.
Yeah, he's in the bomb site. Forrest running in. He's going to be able to spot anyone to connect. Jumps down onto the stair, onto the ladder, and then tries to even take the aim duel. He's going to go down. Seuss with a great double kill. Headshots happening, and now he exists in a 1-on-3. His time is just going to run out, and he might die after the time, in fact, which would be a big blow to NIP's economy.
And like I said, the problem for NIP was that they didn't have enough smoke left so that they would cover the entire bomb site, and both Getright and Freiburg were just very low, so it was easy for whoever that was in tower, I believe, seized, and then Zeus in the inner bomb site to get those first initial kills.
But losing that round means NIP, well, it's going to take a, you know, big chunk out of their economy, but they can still buy in this round. No AWP on either side. They've just all given up on that, or they can't buy it because of their economy. Either way, it is 14-11 here, and Na'Vi, if they win the next 5 rounds in a row, will that be impressive? It seems like that will be that'd be kind of a challenge. Flashbangs out, just making a little bit of noise towards boiler room here. Oh, not boiler room, ladder room.
Let's see, NIP are getting ready to attack the inner bomb site here. Coming in through the smokes here in the lower, Guardian spamming, gets a nice kill on Getright, opens up the round. Private just pushing through, gets the first kill. Is he gonna get more?
Freiburg has been on fire in this B bomb site, so I wouldn't be surprised. And the fact that he's so close is really cool, because NaVi might not be checking that close. They're pretty focused on the back of the bomb site and where the bomb is. So if they're just a little bit unfocused, that's going to be it. Oh, but actually he takes the kill anyway. Looked like Freiburg had the opportunity then. Now it's existent for Flareon left. 2-on-4 here. Edward very low on health. That bomb is ticking away. They got to move quickly. Seize gets the kill. Flareon defending in a 1-on-3, and they do have kits. This is almost impossible for him to do. He peeks out. Wild Flash. This. Oh, no! He doesn't get the kill. That was very close. But it will be the counter-terrorist picking up the round. I mean, that looked like it was dead on.
It really did. But I do think NaVi still would have had time for another person to jump on the defuse if they would have been able to cover the cover Flareon then. But 14-12, an IP on their last buy that they're going to be able to afford if they lose this round. So
yeah,
a big round. NaVi have a slightly more money, but they don't have rounds to play with. Azuz did not see that, I don't think. Did he?
No, he's walking right behind, though. This is... Oh, this does a double take and takes down Exist. Now they're all coming. He gets another one. Finally going to go down. But that's well worth the investment from Azuz's point of view. Actually, really well played. Now inside the bombsite, Guardian the one defending. They're rushing down on him, and Freiburg again with the opening kill. Goes for another one, very nearly gets it on Edward. He's going to go down subsequently to Getright. Now Edward with... Actually, he burns Getright to death. So there it is now, Flareon 1-on-2 here.
It's going to be really tough for Flareon to win this round. I mean, the bomb's down, right down in the site. It's actually getting tagged through the smoke, down to just 30 health points. And it might actually even make sense at this point for Flareon to save. But
he's not feeling it.
See.
He really wants to go for it. See if he can be the hero here. Still some time left, 30 seconds for him, and he's got some grenades on him as well. They're already spamming through the smoke, but now that they cut that out, he might be able to walk in here and see if he can get the kill. Just needs to make this two one-on-ones instead of a 1-on-2. There's the first one now. Just one more headshot here. He flared. Oh, so close, but seized. We'll take him down. And that is NaVi winning another very close round. But, I mean, they're holding on Lurpus right now.
Yeah, they're just not giving up, obviously. Nice play by Zeus here. Just double checks that no one's actually walking through the smoke. That he should kill first. Gets the double kill there. Smart play by Zeus. Actually, Zeus actually very similar to how he used to play in 1.6. He really was the first, I believe, the first player person to really master playing behind the smokes in the wide world area in NaVi.
Is that Getright dropping a 30 bomb here in the second map? I think it is. And Freiburg's going to go down. The entry fragger gone. Edward picks up a kill on Forest as well. And actually, it's NIP with just pistols. They get the bomb down in that smoke towards the barrel. Very nicely done here from NIP. It's going to give them an $800 bonus. And it's still a 1-on-3, but that will be the end of it. Edward picking up a lot of kills. I think that's a triple for him in that round.
And that's 14-14 now. All of a sudden, NaVi with more money on the easier side of the map. This is going to be a close series.
If NIP lose at 16-14, that would obviously be upsetting for... I mean, they've been looking very close to winning this for quite a while now. And NaVi only sort of barely hanging on. It's down to 1-on-1s at the end of the round. But they're still here, and the score is tied now. And did they pick up an AWP this time? Yes, they did. So maybe that's going to be the deciding difference. Guardian, if he hits that entry kill, that just might be it.
NIP going for a fast push, so they're mixing things up now.
Yeah, already down on Ivy. They run out. Freiburg opens up. The return from Seized immediately, and Freiburg is gone. Now they're waiting. Two people here from NIP. They're trying to look under the train, see what's going on, if they can get the position of anybody, and they do. Guardian is down. Seized is down. Starix and Seuss are left. 2-on-4, and this would put NIP not just at map, but also match point. Seuss will take down Forest, and it's not over yet. Actually, the bomb is dropped sort of out in the middle of nowhere in man's land here.
Starix does some damage to get right in Ivy. Still a tough 2v3, but the next kill is going to open up this round a lot.
Starix has him locked in behind Electric Box. Tries to grenade his way out, but that's a very good position from Starix. Takes him down. Now he's going to be walking back, and Getright is here. And this is where Getright is the absolute best. Just waiting and timing things perfectly. Look, it just seems like he knows exactly what's about to happen. And he misses the kill!
The shot on Starix!
Wow, in spite of that really, really great positional play, he actually whiffed that shot.
That's very un-Garrett-like. Because he played that perfectly, like he always does, but
yeah,
just missed that easy shot there at the end. Still, 100 health for Exist. Starix and Zeus have 50 combined. He could still clutch this round here.
I don't
but
think
I think he is going to be flanked here in the ladder room.
realize it. Actually, that makes him turn around with another decoy. Gets the one there. Exist now one-on-one and one bullet on Cyrus. It's going to end and Exist sprays. He gets the headshot and NIP one round away. 15 rounds here. Oh, that was not what NaVi needed.
No, that was not. That was, I guess in the end, a bit of a poor timing from NaVi. The way they attacked from ladder room and the guy from Z allowed...
A little bit too quick back in the studio.
Allowed Exist to take on him one at a time.
NaVi don't have the best equipment for the last round, but they can still make it work. Freiburg rushing in. This is fast from NIP. Again, the opening frag. Freiburg seems to have been maybe 80% of the time him just opening up here in the B bomb site. And they are just barreling down on NaVi. They're not showing any respect. It's time for NIP to see if they can do this, but NaVi's holding on. This might actually be overtime. 3-on-3 is the situation. The bomb is down. And NaVi, they need to retake this. They gotta try and stay alive. Get right pushing up. He's gonna, oh, not get the kill. Edward with an incredible save. That timing was perfect. Forrest trying to hold on from up top. He's looking for the kill. He's doing good damage. NaVi aren't defusing yet. It's a 1-on-2. Forrest gets the kill. The defuse is happening. He's gonna wait. Oh, and there it is. The overtime. Edward fully committed to that defuse. And now what is gonna happen here, Lerpus? I mean, does that change how this game plays out?
I mean, I think once we get into overtime and it all resets, you gotta give NIP the advantage here. Slight one, but just nice play by Forrest here, getting these kills. Smart play, not peeking, but unfortunately, just happened to be the wrong play this time around. I mean, this game deserves to go to overtime.
Yeah, it does. It does definitely deserve to go to overtime. All right, are we going to bring it back in the studio real quick, I think, maybe, while they save it for... All right, no back to the studio, we're straight live again. So, overtime here, and the rules, it looks like it's going to be MR3 and I guess 10,000 starting money, which is, seems like it.
And team's not changing sides. NIP going for the same fast rush they just ran on the second and last round that won them around.
Seized. Burns with Farron, actually. Nicely done. Edward with the kill here. So a good start for NaVi in the overtime. Now it's going to be a 4-on-3. And up the ladder, Edward gets a kill. Now jumping down onto the train. He's looking for more. He's going to get more as well. And it's going to be down to get right. 1-on-4. And this might be too much even for the Swedish superstar here. Not easy. Edward. Wow. 4 kills. And look now. NaVi look fired up here. This might happen. This might still happen.
And a quad kill by Edward. What a way to start the overtime.
They still look hyper-focused at this point. You can't really blame them. This is the difference between NaVi pushing it to a third map or getting knocked out 2-0 of the grand finals.
And I'm not sure if anybody else can hear this through our mics or something. There's actually people chanting NaVi now, right in front of our studio.
They're feeling it right now. But Seized goes down as the first man here, and the entry frag of Forrest this time. I'd like to get some stats on how many entry frags Freiburg's got in the B-bomb site for this game. That could be a fun stat, I think, because it seems like he's very successful doing that.
Quite a few. And let's see if NaVi can recover from losing the first man here in Seized. Seized has been a very good player for them, too.
Yeah.
It's going to be a tough pill to swallow. Looks like NIP... still undecided on where they want to go. The bomb is still down by T-Spawn right next to Forest as two of their members try to take over the white wall area. 45 seconds left on the round.
One guy very nearly get his kneecap shot off them, but he was just quick enough to fall back. And I think actually Guardian may have spotted that, so they should be ready for this push that's coming to the A-bomb side. Three people out here defending for NaVi, and they need every single one of them to step it up now. Get right waiting, and he's going to go down. Starix with an important kill. Zeus gets one. Edward gets one. Excellent headshot on Freiburg. Forrest tries to get it here. Exist going to get one as well. It's back to a 2-on-2. It's not done yet. Forrest shooting Starix in the knees, and it's going to be Guardian here. 1-on-2. He's got the AWP. I'm not sure they know where he is, and that might be the only thing working for him right now. Just creeping up.
It's a damn near impossible 1v2. And Forrest with a nice headshot to finish that one off. And that's gonna be 1-1 here in the first overtime.
It looked like Forrest was just actually pretending like he didn't know, and then he walked out with 100% determination to get that headshot. Like, there was no doubt in his mind.
That's a sick shot by Forrest there early on, so yeah. I didn't even see the first one. That means Forrest actually got 4 kills that round.
stunning round from Forrest, no doubt about that. That makes it 16-16. Now the last round of the first half of the overtime is coming up. And currently we're looking for the first team to get 19 rounds. That's the number we're looking for here for either of the teams. That's the way the format works.
And I really think NaVi must win this round to really have a chance.
Agreed.
I mean, they had a good T side. Yeah, sure. They won three weapon rounds, I think.
Yeah.
But the likelihood of them winning even two to tie it up if they lose this one is just very slim. As two first entry kills go to NIP's two superstars, Forrest and Getright.
Yeah, oh, Guardian close gets the one here. This is an important return. Getright got that kill by opening up onto the up on the fence here. Fifaron takes down Guardian. Now it's on Edward. One on four. He's in a good corner. He's going to try and save as much time, but that actually got him killed at the end. I mean, I think it was still... If you want to do a one on four, you got to try something truly crazy like that. If you just shoot the first person that comes by, they know where you are and you're still in the one on three, so not going to blame Edward for that one, but... Almost an unwinnable situation either way you look at it. Starix, there, he was the first man to went down. He was just peeking with a smoke grenade. I mean, stood completely still. That seemed maybe a little bit too bold.
Well, we see Forrest and Getright really stepping it up here in the second map of the grand final. 33 and 32 frags for the two of them in 33 rounds so far. So
yeah,
the superstars are definitely here to play.
Freiburg immediately picks up an auto sniper, and there's also an AWP and Flaren. So NIP not wasting any time picking up the heavy artillery here. They got the money.
That actually puts a lot of pressure on NIP money-wise, because they spent so much money on this first overtime round.
Yeah, when 10,000 is starting, yeah, they lose this round, they could be out of money very quickly.
Well, I mean, they'd have to lose both, but if they were to lose two weapon rounds, that'd be enough for NaVi, essentially, because NIP would be flat-out broke for the third one.
If we go back to the NaVi, look at this. Yeah, this is the smoke execute that we were sort of asking for the whole game, the whole first half. We were wanting NaVi to do this play, and now they're doing it. The smoke's rain in, and they're going to be ready here at the A bomb site, down towards where the scope rifles are, and onto the site for the plant here. Nicely coordinated by NaVi. Let's see if it works or if it's going to be a failure. Already, Forrest with the pickoff, and there it is. Double kill from Forrest. Very nicely done. Freiburg chimes in. It's going to be seized and Edward left. This push is not working so well right now. Edward's alone against three people from NIP. And I think they know where he is because Getright's got him boxed in. Oh, this is going to be just a pure execution. He's going to walk up and Getright takes the kill. No issue. 18-16. NIP have two more rounds to get just a single one. And they will knock NaVi out of this tournament.
Not only knock them out, they're going to win the tournament.
That too.
Two game points for NIP now here as counter-terrorist on train, I might add.
Yeah, the last time these teams met on LAN was for the SLTV Star Series Finals, where, well, first of all, in the upper bracket, NaVi won 2-0. Then in the finals, they won 2-0 again. That was in Kiev, in Ukraine. But this is Jönköping in Sweden, and it's NIP's home turf, and it looks like they just might be able to do it. They just need a single round, and that will be it. And they still have the auto sniper. They still have the AWP.
This is a slow round for NaVi. They definitely don't want to commit too early. It goes to the other end of the ladder room. Luckily for Edward, that would have been dangerous otherwise. This NaVi playing super, super slow, super far back. Guardian still all the way back in spawn. Exist is going to be spotted by Edward, and he's going to get taken out there.
If that flash had been 1 second earlier, it felt like maybe Edward would have died instead. But
yeah,
good timing.
And Guardian also picks up Forrest. Flying replies on Zeus. It's a 4-on-3 now in favor of NaVi. Actually, make that a 3v3. I guess Getright takes out Starry.
Freiburg at the end. Auto sniper works. Now 3-on-2. Seized and Edward holding Navi's tournament life in their hands. They get the one kill in. Edward with a great headshot. That's a double for him. Spraying away his Getright and not hitting the shots. Well, oh, through the smoke! Yeah. Are you kidding me? Now it's a 1-on-2. And Edward, he's going to have to get a quad here. Time is also running out. 20 seconds. He's trying to plant it. As soon as he steps up. Oh, he actually unscopes Fiflaren. A little bit of a misplay. He goes for another one. Edward's boxed in. And there it is. Fiflaren takes the kill. And NIP, they are the champions for the DreamHack Steel Series CSGO Championship here, DreamHack Summer. Unbelievable play from them at the end.
Look at Garrett.
Oh man, yeah, it's Heaton's birthday just a few days ago, so I guess this is a pretty good way of celebrating as well. His team winning at the very end. And the crowd, they're on their feet as well. This is, yeah, this is what they needed. And obviously an emotional moment for Garrett as well. I think they look like they were getting worried at the end with overtime and all.
What a fantastic performance, really. I mean, Get Right in particular, who was actually